appreciate the opportunity to meet you over the past year. I appreciate how much support you've lended to Medicaid. I probably wouldn't be here today if it weren't for Medicaid helping me get care for my childhood depression. And I appreciate that you've co-sponsored the Early Child Act and the READ Act USA policies. I saw your statement published online about the Trump budget, and I appreciated how bold you've been about that. It's good that your statement specifically calls for a bipartisan budget agreement to lift the non-defense discretionary caps. And I understand that as a Democrat, you do not have a formal role in crafting a budget resolution, but you play an important role in the public debate over the budget by speaking out and you educate your constituents. As someone concerned about poverty programs and inequality in this country, I'm encouraging you to call for a budget that protects critical investments both at home and abroad, protects poverty reduction programs and other programs for the most vulnerable in this country, and ensures the tax reform is revenue neutral.
Good. sounds about right. And you know, you don't sound like a big spender to me. You sound like someone who understands that you need fiscal balance, you need fiscal a fiscal plan going forward. But it is not a fiscal plan at all. It's just to whack away incessantly at the domestic discretionary portion of the budget. That's 17% of the budget, and it bears the brunt of 100% of the Trump budget's efforts at deficit reduction. And as I said earlier, that gives you the worst of both worlds. You don't solve the deficit that way. We solved the deficit for a while back in the 90s. 4 years of surpluses. What's wrong with that? A roaring economy. What's wrong with that? But we did it by biting the bullet, and it was not popular, by the way. Not popular to do that menu of raising taxes and cutting entitlements and restraining discretionary spending. But I still think those are among the best votes I ever cast. And our politics just makes that impossible right now, although we need it more than ever. So now I guess this savaging of Medicaid is not the first time we've heard this. This has been a part of Ryan budgets for a long time, but it's much, much worse now. And let me just revisit this for a second, because there seems to be an idea out there that what the Trump budget and the Republican budget have proposed is simply rolling back Medicaid expansion, which, by the way, is to this state's abiding disgrace that we didn't expand Medicaid when we could. And I hope we still can find a way to do it. But
Senator Burr told me in D.C. that that was not going to happen.
Yeah, but the Medicaid proposals we're dealing with here cut back Medicaid proper. This has nothing to do with the Affordable Care Act. This is Medicaid that we've counted on, that so many people in long-term care count on. That's a dirty little secret, by the way. People have no idea how much of long-term care in this country comes out of Medicaid. It's just very, very